you know, the way this game ended, certainly did not think it was going to end that way, the way it was developing. But let's go back to the start, Boomer, and James Paxton, his second start back after the knee injury. What'd you see from him tonight?
Well, he just didn't have his command. He was all over the place, pretty much down the middle like last night with Tanaka. But, you know, when you're out there, you got something on the line. You're going out there, you're trying to win a series. You know, it ended, but the thing is that you can't put yourself in a situation that early and not be in command of your pitches and leave them over, because it's kind of been a trend for the last two nights.
Well, so James Paxton goes 4 2/3. Yankees dig out of a hole. Offense gives them a three-run lead, but they're unable to hold on, and the streak of 9 straight series ends tonight, David.
Yeah, streak buster on both sides, right? The Blue Jays obviously was on the other end of it, lost their, you know, ended their losing streak. So this is, to me, there's a lot of blame to go around. Defensive errors, the bullpen, the vaunted Yankees bullpen certainly didn't do their job, but you win as a team, you lose as a team. That was a team loss in my mind.
Well, the Yankees will turn tomorrow to Jay Happ, and Boomer, you lose the series, that streak's over, but of course, final game of a road series, you still want to leave with a win.
Well, you want to have a happy flight, and that's usually, even though you lose the series, happy flight, you're going to salvage something out of it. But, you know, the thing is that they know what they have to do. They've got the team out there. They've got the ability. Let's just go back in there, dig deep, and have a better day tomorrow. They got a good lefty on the mound as well.
Well, Jay Happ, the former Blue Jay, will have that chance to salvage the final game of this three-game set. Tonight, it's an 11-7 loss for the Yankees in Toronto.